The fourth candle of the Advent wreath is lit. Homes are decorated with trees and lights. Nativity scenes are arranged. Stockings are hung. Gifts are purchased. Even in the midst of a pandemic, signs of hope abound. There's no doubt that this Christmas will be unlike any we have celebrated. Families will not gather. There will be no packed church. No, O come all ye faithful, sung by the gathered people of God. No silent night, comforting the soul. Yet the heart of Christmas, the celebration of the nativity of Christ, will still take place. On this final Sunday before Christmas, the sacred scriptures invite us to stop for a moment and to pay attention to our innermost self. We've heard the story of the angel Gabriel greeting Mary and inviting her to bring about the birth of God into the world. Mary struggles with what is being asked of her, but ultimately she unites her will with God's. The result? Conception of the Christ. As Gabriel greeted Mary, so God greets each one of us in the secret recesses of the heart. God invites each of us to join the work of the gospel. We too are invited to let Christ be conceived in our hearts so as to help bring God's justice, Jesus, into the world. Are we willing to be the dwelling place of God's word? Are we willing to be the dwelling place of Christ? Are we willing to allow God to seed the world with new possibilities? God needs people willing to help society so that everyone's innate dignity is respected. God is on a recruiting mission, trying to awaken our true identity as God's children. When the angel spoke to Mary, her heart caught fire. Are we willing to let God inflame our hearts? Normally at this time of year, there are lots of opportunities to help society treat everyone more justly, with greater dignity. This year, it has been much more difficult, but the need is greater than normal. Local food banks need our help to see to it that everyone has something to eat. Catholic Charities is also asking for our support. The next 2 months are going to be extremely difficult. The fourth candle is lit. Our homes are decorated. Gifts are purchased. How is God asking us to give birth to Christ this Christmas?